Botox. So urge incontinence, as we discussed in another video, is when the bladder starts contracting uncontrollably, when it's not necessarily being asked to. So if you're trying to pee and your brain says, okay, contract, and then it contracts, then that's great. But the problem is that sometimes the bladder sort of does its own thing and starts contracting when, you know, without you asking it to. So what are the solutions? Well, first line therapies are considered like oral medications. For example, you know, medications like Vesicare, or medications like oxybutynin, or newer medications like beta-3 adrenergic receptor agonists like mirabetrig. That's another medication. Ultimately, the medications may work, and may work only for a time, and may not work. They may work, but they may have side effects. So some people, eventually, they'll say, okay, I don't want to take those medications. Is there anything else? Well, there is. What we can do, and this is a pretty effective treatment, there's a couple of different treatments, that procedures that can be done. One of them is Botox. But it turns out that, guess what? Not only can you inject Botox in your eyelids, or forehead, or various different places in your head, but you can also inject it in the muscle of your bladder. If we inject 20 pokes in the bladder of Botox, the whole thing lasts about a minute or two to actually perform, and it provides good relief in a lot of cases, because all of a sudden, those contractions that are spastic, they're sort of spasms in the bladder that are contracting, they don't propagate throughout the bladder as well as they would without the Botox. So let's say, for example, a contraction started here in the bladder. Instead of the whole bladder going like this, well, there'll be like several different interruptions. And it's just been shown to be very effective. The benefits of getting a Botox injection rather than medications is it's very, very localized. So you don't have to drug your whole body with receptor blockers or receptor agonists and have side effects in your eyes, in your mouth, in your ears, and everywhere in your body. Botox is very localized. If you inject Botox in your bladder, you're not going to have dry mouth. You're not going to have dry ears. You're going to have a bladder that doesn't contract as much. So that's a huge plus. But what are the possible negative effects? Well, you do have to get Botox every 6 months. Unfortunately, Botox does not last forever. So if you have a good result with Botox 6 months later, unfortunately, you have to repeat the procedure, because we haven't found a Botox that works forever as of yet. You know, eventually the Botox wears out and you have to get another treatment, which means another visit to the urologist, another cystoscopy, another injection. Another, you know, it's not the end of the world, but this does take about an hour out of your day to get it done, which is, you know, it's a procedure. So that's the biggest drawback. But Botox otherwise is a great procedure. It works very well, and it sort of avoids taking medications every day and getting a lot of side effects from those medications.